to another Wacom product review. Today we're gonna have a look at this little guy. It's a new Copen 3D and it has no eraser but three customizable buttons. Now I usually never use the pen buttons, I use the keyboard shortcuts, so it will be interesting to see how this works out. Let's have a look.
Alright, let's make a little zebra sculpt. I start by blocking out the main shapes of the sculpt using basically the move brush, the clay build-up brush, a little bit the Damien standard brush to carve in and make some marks, and some masking of course. So as you know, you can always press the Alt key to make the opposite of the chosen brush. So if you chose the clay build-up brush and you press Alt while using it, you carve into the material. Same with the move brush and for example the Damien standard brush, instead of carving in you make a little ridge. So if you set up the pin buttons accordingly, for example Control for the masking and spacebar menu to change the brush size and the Alt key, then you can basically do this whole first part just with the pen, just with the left or right hand on the pen, and no need for shortcuts or anything else. Here I use an insert mesh brush to add eyes. If you use the insert mesh brush, they are auto-masked, so you can split them apart and have a different subtool, and then work independently on the eyes and on the rest of the head. As I go along, I increase the dynamesh resolution, so I just have more material to create more and more little details as I go along. You can see here, carving in occasionally with the Damien standard brush as a guide basically. Here I assign a different material to the eyes. This is not necessary of course, but I just like the look of it, so I usually do it. And yeah, and I continue defining more areas, adding more detail. I continue increasing the dynamesh resolution and adding more and more details, fleshing out the features of the creature face. And all this is just done with the basic functions like adding material, carving in, moving a bit, some masking occasionally. So, as I said, you can do all this with a pen. This might be very handy for use of tablet displays, where you might not want to rely on the keyboard. And of course, you have shortcut express keys and etc. The pen would just add a bit more flexibility on top. So we're now approaching the phase where we would add a lot more smaller details. Depending on what you plan to do with your sculpt, now you could go and project the whole mesh and detail on a clean mesh. So you could have subdivisions and maybe move the head or put it in a pose and stuff like that. But we don't need this here since it's just a basic demo sketch. So I just keep on increasing the dynamesh resolution, and so I can just sculpt away and add smaller and smaller details. Taking the standard brush and applying an alpha texture to it, so I can add a lot of little skin detail to the entire sculpt, make it just a bit more interesting. So for the final phase, I just take some different brushes and work on all the areas again of the face, and just refine little details and work on some parts, flesh them out a bit more to make them more interesting. And that's basically it. We are almost done now. Something I noticed during the sculpting is that I really have to focus on using the pen buttons. I'm so used to using the keyboard shortcuts that it's basically become a reflex. I could adapt, of course, if needed, but I would need to take some time to get used to it. Alright, to wrap it up, time to take the little guy to KeyShot and make a nice render.
So, what's my conclusion? If like me, the keyboard shortcuts are so ingrained in your muscle memory, it might take some time to adapt to using the buttons, and maybe this is not for you. Now, if like a lot of my teammates, you actually use the buttons a lot, then this might be interesting for you, since you have a lot more options to customize the pen to your needs. So however you decide, happy ZBrushing, happy modeling, happy sculpting, and see you in the next one.